Man, I'm gonna make this quick. What's going on over there at Microsoft? Now, I waited until I was able to do this, till I could get hands on the game. I quickly deleted it out of my Xbox. I gave it an hour of my time. An hour. Redfall, bruh? Is this what the $7 billion that was spent on Bethesda is getting us? Now, I know Starfield is coming. Let's leave that out of the conversation. That's an unknown quantity at this time. It ain't like we can look at. Shit, we can barely look at anybody these days when it's coming to making these games and say, I trust that. I damn near don't look at nobody and say, I trust that. But Bethesda ain't been on that level since what? I don't know the last. If Bethesda hadn't had fucking id Software crank out those two Dooms, and maybe Arcane put out Prey over the last, what, 7-8 years? I say maybe about Prey because that one is kind of hit or miss whether people like it or not. I think it's all right. But the two Dooms, Doom Eternal, Doom 2016, I mean, that shit is just rocking from start to finish. But if Bethesda didn't have that going, what would they fucking have? Fallout 4, which is fucking boring, which is not damn comparable to 3 or New Vegas, in my opinion. And then Fallout 76. I mean, they had the Evil Within 1 and 2, but not exactly my cup of tea, but not complete dog shit. But Redfall? For fuck's sake, like, I'm not one to sit up here and follow a bunch of reviews and hop on the train, but damn, I ain't seen nothing in the negative reviews that I saw worth a buy skill up. G-Man, ACG, I saw all of those. I haven't seen nothing that they said that was wrong. The shit is gone. It's long gone. I'm not downloading it again. It's fucking terrible. I mean, look. This shit, and of course, I don't have a capture card and all of that stuff, so I can't really show. But I wouldn't even had enough to edit together a video to show what I'm talking about. Because after an hour of struggling through that shit, I was done. The cutscenes are displayed as slideshows. That's fine and dandy. It's the least of the concerns when it comes to this game. I just know when I put hands on the controller and I'm shooting a gun at something, it can't feel like I'm shooting fucking marshmallows and Nerf bullets. Like, nothing in the game has any impact. And number two, the game looked like it needs lotion. It's ashy as fuck. The game is mad ashy. It got like a overly, I don't know, like some type of pale overlay over the color palette that makes everything looks like it needs a layer of good moisturizer. But anyway, back to how I feel. Like, the number one thing in a shooter is shooting. And when you fuck up the shooting part, you fucked up the whole game. Like, nothing has weight. It feels like I'm shooting marshmallows and somebody puts the toilet down. And like, people wait until I'm recording this shit at 1 a.m. to start doing shit. But anyway, it feels like I'm shooting marshmallows and Nerf bullets. Nothing has impact. Now, for reference. I was playing the new storyline expansion, the Xenoblade Chronicles 3, before I picked this up to go and play it. And when you use the character, like the main character Matthew from that game, and he uses his attacks and you do his special attacks or his arts, he uses his fists, and when you do the arts, it feels like he's knocking the shit out of something. On the other hand, I'm shooting fucking guns in Redfall. It feels like I'm just shooting feathers at vampires. Now, I will say, on the positive side, when you finally down a vampire enough to stab it with the stake, that has some impact. That got a little visual flair. But after you do it 4 or 5 times, it's like, okay, what next? I might be selling it short. I never got to a boss fight. I realized 20 minutes into the game that I was never going to make it to a boss fight. And I'm not going to go back and make it to a boss fight. I don't give a fuck if they put 1,000 frame per second patch out. I'm never playing this game again. It ain't a thing in the world you can do to make me be intentionally bored when I have a choice. Like, you can put out any patches you want. At the base, at the root of this game, the game is fucking boring. And it's nothing, no weight to the combat. Like, I'm shooting at one of the vampire dudes, and he just floating there looking at me while I'm shooting. And I'm just standing there 10 feet away from him with a shotgun, whittling his health away. Shot him until he dropped to his knees, walked up to him, stabbed him, and kept it moving. And just kept it moving. Like, maybe I'm giving it an unfair shake because I didn't get to see every mechanic, but why the fuck? Like, I'm not one of those just give it 5 hours then it gets good motherfuckers. Like, I'm not one of them, because if a game is shit, then it's shit from the start. And if it's good, most of the time it's good from the start. Like, what's a good example of that? Like, I don't know, a lot of people hate on Final Fantasy 13 and they say give it, but this is the thing. And they say give it until you get to Pulse, then it finally opens up and stops being a fucking hallway, and that's when it gets good. And maybe that's your opinion, but to me, Final Fantasy 13, at least the world I was in was interesting enough for me to keep running straight down the hallway. And the battles was fun enough that I didn't mind doing them while I was running down the hallway until the damn game opened up. This has none of that. I'm not giving it 5 hours until it gets good. I'm not giving it 5 more minutes. Microsoft, but y'all motherfuckers better tighten up, because Starfield aside, I don't know about that. I mean, for my personal taste, Forza Motorsport 8 is what can save your asses. I'm actually looking forward to that. Like, Starfield, I'm going to play it, but Bethesda I have no trust in. Forza Motorsport 8 is what can rescue you clowns, because shit, you fucked Halo. That's dead and buried, like I predicted it would be and hoped that it wouldn't be before it ever came out when it got delayed that first time. That's dead and buried. That's done. When Halo got delayed away from the launch of the Xbox Series X, I knew it was done. I was hoping not, but I was right. God damn. I can't even. I mean, Forza Horizon 5, I mean, objectively a good game, but for me, it just didn't hit. I couldn't do it. Like, I don't know, maybe I'm biased. Nothing that I played Forza Horizon wise, like the Australia setting is just so in rarefied air for me. I love it so much. I just don't think, unless they take us to Japan, I don't think Forza Horizon is gonna capture me the way that 3 did. So I ain't gonna say Forza Horizon 5 is bad, but I just didn't feel compelled to spend the time that I did with 3 or even 4. But come on, dog. The shit that happened with Halo, the shit that's going on with Redfall, Starfield being delayed 15 or 16 times, it seems like. When are we gonna get something that's worth a damn out of y'all? Instead of showing us games that you know ain't coming out until 2026, why the fuck we even know about Perfect Dark? Why we even need to know that? That was never gonna come out anywhere near the time you talked about it. What was the purpose? To hype up something for, hype up some shit for people that hot damn 10% of them that was hyped for it when it was announced is probably gonna be dead by the time it comes out. Perfect Dark, Fable. We ain't gonna see that shit. That these games are launching in the next 12 months. Nigga, where? We ain't about to see that. We ain't about to see. When at this point, I'm wondering if we gonna even see Forza Motorsport 8 in 2023, because that ain't even got a date yet. And as hot damn much as I think it might be, or it got a great chance to be better than Gran Turismo 7, at least Gran Turismo 7 came the fuck on out. At least I can play that if I want to. I haven't wanted to lately, but damn, Forza Motorsport is supposed to be out last year, and it ain't even out right now. Like, something, this Game Pass initiative, Microsoft got so many eggs in that basket that it seemed like it's promote Game Pass first and make games that's worth a fuck second. That's what it seemed like to me. And Redfall, I mean, it's going to be some bullshit ass statistic. Redfall hit 10 million players or 2 million players. Yeah. How many people bought the motherfucker though? Except for downloading it on Game Pass. Because, of course, I mean, you can count me as a player. I played it for an hour. I ain't got a download. It got a swift delete, but it got a download. Stop with these fake-ass numbers, man, trying to boost up the shit. Marketing speak. This game had this many players and that many players. How many people went and dropped $70 on this shit game? $70 for this. You should have delayed this motherfucker all the way to like November or something. Get it away from, because this guy, I mean, you really wanted to put it out a week before Tears of the Kingdom and a month before Final Fantasy 16, and you ain't got shit else that's coming to follow this bullshit up all the way into September allegedly, and Starfield might not even come out then. Look, how was you? You might as well, you done delayed the fucker already. Like, you might as well should have just delayed it on again. And I know IGN ain't the most reputable source, but I think in this case, the guy playing the game wasn't dog shit that made it look crazy. The game is just dog shit. I mean, I played it and I was bored. It was trash. It felt like I was shooting Nerf bullets, as I already said. And I didn't even get to the point where I was upgrading anything with perk points or unlocking new weapons. I just deleted shit so I could download Guilty Gear Strive on my Xbox instead. So, you know, Microsoft, please stop releasing dog shit. And I'm going to be back soon to address this Jedi Survivor shit. I'm going to be back real soon to address that. Because of EA, because of y'all bullshit, I can't even buy a game I want because it's in such a shit state. But until then, where's the fucking stop button? Stop.